I think before I was a musician, I wanted to be a writer. But I was quite young when I became a musician, so I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do in anything. But yeah, I would have liked to have been a writer, but I don't. Writing on paper is a lot more difficult than writing music, I think. Well, my whole family was quite into music, and my dad used to run a recording studio, so I guess I grew up around it. I first started playing guitar when I was about five. My dad taught me on a nylon string. I guess I began writing songs and doing gigs and stuff when I was 16. I started gigging. I guess I was writing music before then, but probably not very noteworthy. Well, I grew up listening to Neil Young and Joni Mitchell and then some English folk stuff like Bert Jansch and John Renbourn and John Martin. So all of those, I mean, those, the English side of it was very much like guitar style, and the American side was more melodic and lyrical, and kind of, because it was America in the 60s, mythical to me. So those are the things that shaped my sound, I guess. When I got nominated for the Mercury, yeah, it was quite a shock, and it was quite, you know, it's a really nice thing, but it was quite scary because up until that point, we've been doing everything nice and slowly, and not ever doing anything that was kind of like, you know, making me uncomfortable or making anybody uncomfortable. The strange thing was that to a lot of people, whoever was paying attention to the Mercurys, I came out of nowhere, but to me it felt like I'd been working really hard for 2 years. I was in that time in two bands. I was playing with a band called Knowing the Whale and also doing my own stuff, and we'd been touring solidly in one of those outfits, because they were all playing with me as well, for 2 years, and it felt, you know, it felt like it had been a lovely, gradual, you know, picking up people who like the music along the way. But you know, it's so nice being recognised. It's a difficult conundrum, I think, for artists. My third album is called A Creature I Don't Know. The title of it was a lyric from a song that I wrote for the album that I didn't actually end up putting on the album, and it was The Beast is a Creature I Don't Know, and if you were to listen to the album, you'd know that there is also a song called The Beast. And that's it. It's kind of like doesn't really conclude that story, but. This last album we did with Ethan Johns. Ethan's just like a pro. I don't know, like he's just about getting the way he likes to record as well, all analog, all in. We're always all in the same room as a band, and he can tell that. I think the biggest part of his genius, other than him being just getting a great sound, is that he can tell a good take, and you can't argue with it. If a take is a sort of honest and not sort of doesn't feel like a dead horse or whatever, he knows it, and he's just good, isn't he? The rules.
Spoke of love like hunger.
Every time an album comes out, it feels like a relief, you know, in lots of aspects, for lots of reasons. And it also it's terrifying as well, which is great. But I'm just looking forward to touring again. You know, I genuinely love playing music. So I'm very, very, very lucky to be doing what I do. But his honesty did leave me blind. Hello, I'm Laura Marling and this is Baeble Music. Tonight, you can come.